Maybe I'll rise in honor of the bride. Special day in joining Lisa and Jeffrey in the union of marriage. And who gives this bride to be?
Wendy and I.
Thank you, sir. Jeffrey, you may receive your bride and bring her forward. Thank you, and you may be seated. Now, a marriage is a uniting of two people, two hearts, onto one common path. And it's that path that the two of you will now share together. The two of you had your individual lives and individual experiences that led you to this point. And it's those experiences, Lisa, that made you the woman that you are here today. And the same for you, Jeffrey. It's those individual experiences that made you the man that you are here. And later on in the ceremony, the unity candle will represent exactly that. Your two lives joined into one life now in marriage. And through your journey together, there's a few things that I hope would carry along its way. It would be that from the heart, to have the ability to listen to one another, what it is that makes them feel whole and part of this relationship. And secondly, the ability to learn what it takes to help the other fulfill everything from the desires, dreams, and goals that they may have. And lastly, the ability to love. To love unconditionally, meaning no strings attached. It's an ongoing love. And this is the type of love that I hope the two of you wish to share with each other, each and every day. So Jeffrey, I'll ask you first. By your presence here today, alongside Lisa, do you take her as your wife in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting her always, allowing nothing or no one to come between the two of you? Do you take her as your wife?
I do.
So I'll ask you the same. By your presence here today, alongside Jeffrey, do you take him as your husband in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting him always, allowing nothing or no one to come between the two of you? Do you take him as your husband?
I do.
If I can have your bouquet, please. I'll have you turn and face each other and take each other's hands. Now, looking into each other's eyes, you will see the very reason why you are here today, proving that there is no one more important than who stands before you. So at this time, Jeffrey, I'll ask you first.
I, Jeff, take you, Lisa, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for rich or for poor, in sickness and health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. I will care for you, honor and protect you. I lay down my life for you, Lisa, my best friend and my love.
Thank you. Lisa, your vows.
Thank you. I vow to love you today, tomorrow, and until the day the moon falls. To embrace your quirks and to encourage your dreams, no matter how often you change your mind. To have the patience that love demands. To cherish each day together, to grow in your love, and to hold your heart in the safest of places, my heart. Most of all, I vow to always be me and to let you be you.
Thank you. Now, your vows that you've just exchanged with each other, they're your promises. They're a pledge that you're making to one another in your marriage together. And at this time, if I could have you step over to the unity candle. And as I mentioned earlier, the two of you had your own separate lives that led you to this moment. And each taper represents those individual lives. But in lighting the center candle, your individual lives will be no more. And it'll be one life, now in marriage, uniting not only each other, but your friends and family as well. So if I could have you take a hold of your individual taper and light the center candle at the same time. And in doing so, you're creating a new journey.
All right, let's try it again.
If I could have you blow out your individual tapers. Thank you. And I'll invite you back to the front of the podium. Now, if you love somebody, you'll be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You'll always stand beside them. You'll always trust them. And you'll stand your ground in defending them no matter what. And there's a saying that I like to leave with you as I see two couples standing next to one another. And it says, don't walk in front of me. I may not follow. Don't walk behind me. I may not lead. But walk beside me as a friend. Because after all, that is what you're building. A deeper, richer, stronger friendship built upon the foundation of your relationship that you already have. And also, something else to keep in mind, that you would love each other not only for who they are, but for what they are helping to make of you. So on the 17th of September, a day that will now mark your anniversary, in the presence of friends and family as witnesses, you've showed your intentions by the exchanging of your vows and the exchanging of your rings. Therefore, with the power vested in me by the state of Nevada, oh, I'm sorry, the rings. Can I have the rings, please?
That's okay.
Thank you very much. Sorry, I threw me off with you guys having your vows.
That's okay.
Well, these rings that the two of you have chosen for each other, they're not only tokens, but they're symbols of the love and devotion that you are expressing here today. And my hope is, in every day, wearing these rings, may it remind you of exactly that promise. And in time, these rings may lose beauty, but I hope that you value and honor wearing these rings for what they truly represent. And through your friends and family, the beauty will shine through you both, and the two of you will be a wonderful example to all. So Jeffrey, I'll ask that you take her ring first and place it upon her ring finger. If you could please repeat after me. With this ring, I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
And I feel so honored.
And I feel so honored.
To call you my wife.
To call you my wife.
So, taking his token, if you could place upon his ring finger. And if you could please repeat after me.
So nervous.
With this ring. I seal my promise. To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
And I feel so honored. To call you my husband.
Okay.
There you go. Well, now with the exchanging of your rings and the exchanging of your own vows, with the power vested in me, it is my honor and my privilege to now be able to pronounce you as husband and wife. Jeffrey, you may now kiss your wife, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, the first dance.
Oh,
Lisa, your bouquet.
Oh, thank you.
If I could have you turn and face your guests and the photographer. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Bodden. Congratulations.